might have the technical difficulties. Amen. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him.
Glory to God. Nobody like our God.
So God, we just magnify you in spite of it all on today. Amen. We're going to forward. Amen. Let's welcome, amen, our online audience. We want to welcome you to New Life Christian Center Church, changing lives with the word of God. Praise God. Amen. We welcome you online, viewing on our website. Amen. NewLifeForYou.org and on YouTube and Facebook. We praise God. Amen. Just for being God. Amen. We don't magnify the attack of the enemy because we already got the victory. Praise God. We already got the victory. Amen. And if I didn't have a microphone, we just still teach the word of God. Amen. Because we depend on the Holy Ghost. Amen. We depend on, amen, the strength of God, the peace of God. Praise the name of the Lord. We depend, amen, mightily on the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Nobody like our God. Amen. And we thank God today, amen, for our being here. Amen. We thank God for what he's doing and how he's doing it. Praise God. Amen. We welcome each of you. Praise God. All of our visitors. We welcome every family. Amen. Those viewing online. We just want to welcome you on today. Praise God. Praise God. Good to see you, Sister Jackson, and your family. Your father and mother, we praise God, amen, for you all coming on today. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, just grab your Bibles, amen, and we're moving past the issues of our technical difficulties. We're going right into the word of God, amen, and we're going to, amen, go forward because we got the victory anyhow, amen. So let's get right into the word of God. Amen. We're still reading, amen, Romans chapter 8 daily. Praise the Lord. And we know, amen, that the word of God, we know the word of God, amen, from our apostle for the 2023 word is living your life as more than a conqueror. Praise God. And on today we have two passages of scripture. Praise the Lord, coming from Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27, and Matthew chapter 11, verse 27 through 30. Praise God. So if you would turn in your Bibles to Isaiah chapter 11, verse 27, praise God, amen, it reads as thus, and it shall come to pass in that day, that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. How many know the anointing destroys every yoke? Praise God. Amen. Let's turn in our Bibles, praise the Lord, over to Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11. Praise the Lord. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11. Praise God. Amen. And we're going to read verses 27 through 30. All things are delivered up. Jesus talking, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, For I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For mine is easy, and my burdens are light. Is God our subject on today? Amen. We're talking about, praise God, wearing the more than a conqueror anointing. Our emphasis today is on conquering yokes and burdens every time. Conquering yokes and burdens every time. You may be seated. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're still, man, reading the book of Romans. How many have been blessed? Amen. Reading Romans, the 8th chapter, every day. Praise God. Amen. It's being a blessing to us. And if you're not reading that passage, I would invite you, amen, to read that passage every day. Have something to write with, amen. God will certainly speak to you. Praise God. Amen. Now from Isaiah chapter 20, chapter 10, verse 27. Praise God. Talking about, amen, the Lord removing the heavy burden off your shoulders. And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off the shoulders, amen, off thy shoulders, and his yoke from off thy neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Praise God. Amen. The Lord, amen, I'm here to tell you today, amen, the Lord will remove the heavy burden off your shoulders. Praise God. And you know, we're not designed to carry heavy burdens, but we got to turn it over to the Lord. Amen. 1 Peter 5 and 7 lets us know to cast all of our cares on him. Why do we cast it on him? Because he cares for you. He loves you. Praise God. He made us in his image and in his likeness. And we're not built or designed to carry the burden. Amen. But cast it over on the Lord. I challenge you today, whatever it is, amen, turn it over to the Lord. Praise God. And whatever health issue, whatever wealth issue, whatever family issue, turn it over to the Lord. Amen. Don't let anything concern you. I'm here to let you know God has it under control. Praise God. So don't carry it another minute longer. Amen. Just turn it over to the Lord. Amen. I want you to know God's got it. And God's got you. Praise God. You don't have to worry. You don't have to fear. He's not giving you a spirit of fear, but power, what else? Love, and sound mind. Praise God. Amen. So don't carry nothing. Just depend on Jesus. See, burdens are like mountains. You're not made to carry them. Praise the Lord. Amen. You're made to speak to the mountain and tell the mountain to move. Praise God. That's why Jesus said in Mark's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 23, verily I say unto you, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things you say shall come to pass, you shall have whatsoever you say. Praise God. So speak to the mountain and tell it to move. Praise God. Speak to the issue and tell it to move. Praise God. Speak to the circumstance and tell it to move. I don't care the situation. Just speak to it today and tell it to move. I'm here to let you know you got power in your words. Amen. You got the anointing of the Holy Ghost in your words. Praise God. When you stand boldly in your authority and you speak the word of God, amen, the end.
says, so use your authority. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So we, amen, know this word talks about, praise God, amen, in Isaiah, the Lord will break off the yoke of bondage from your neck. In other words, the yoke will be destroyed because of the anointing. How many know it's the anointing that destroys the yoke? Every yoke of bondage. Praise God. And you already got the anointing on the inside of you. Praise God. If you don't realize that, that's 1 John 2:27. The anointing that you have received of him. Amen. It abided in you. Praise God. So use your anointing. Amen. And destroy every yoke off of your life. Praise God. In other words, amen, and you can use your anointed authority and speak to every situation that doesn't line up with the word. Praise God. I want you to know if your health is out of balance and it's not aligning itself with the word. Amen. Psalms 107:20, it says, the Lord sent his word and what? Healed you and delivered you from all your destruction. Amen. He healed in H-E-A-L-E-D. It's past tense. Praise God. It's already done. You were healed before you went to the doctor. You were healed before he gave you the report. Amen. You're healed already. And when Jesus went to the cross, he said, it is finished. It was finished. Your healing was finished. Your deliverance was finished. Amen. And your salvation was finished. Praise God. Your prosperity was finished. Amen. Your victory was finished. Even before you knew what it was. Amen. Before you knew how to walk in victory. Praise God. He said, it is finished. Praise the mighty name of the Lord. Amen. You got the victory on today. So use your anointed authority. Anything that don't line up with the word, speak to it. Amen. Speak the word to it. Change your situation. Praise God. Change the circumstance. Praise God. You can do it. Just not at your neighbor. You can do it. Praise God. Give him a hand. Praise right there. Praise the name of the Lord. Now when we look at Matthew's Gospel chapter 11, verse 27 through 30, praise God, Isaiah chapter 10 and Matthew chapter 11 singularly speak of yokes and burdens. Praise God, you're not supposed to carry burdens, amen, because that takes away your rest. Praise God. God wants you to enter in to that rest. Praise God. Now Hebrews chapter 4 verse 9 says there remaineth a rest for the people of God. I don't care what the situation is. There remaineth a rest for the people of God. But you got to enter into it. Praise God. Verse 11 says, let us labor therefore to what? Enter into that rest. Praise God. There's a rest from every burden. There's a rest from every fear. There's a rest from every circumstance. Oh, y'all don't hear me. There's a rest. Amen. From every stress. From every pressure. Amen. From every situation. Amen. It's time. I don't know who this word is for, but it's time for you. Amen. Amen. He's your oasis in every situation. Praise God. I want you to know you will find refreshment. You will find rest in me for your soul. We're talking about wherefore the more than the conqueror anointing. Amen. Yokes and burdens. Destroying yokes and burdens every time. Praise God. Now listen to me. Once you conquer the yoke of the enemy, we can't go unyoked. In other words, uncontrolled. See, when you put the yoke on, amen, I'm talking about a godly yoke. See, there's certain places you can't go. Amen. There's certain things you can't say. Praise the Lord, because you're wearing this yoke. Can I get a witness here? Amen. I call it the yoke of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Amen. It'll keep you from wrong places. It's a protective yoke. Amen. To keep you from breaking out of your green pastures. Praise God. God got green pastures for your life. Amen. Say amen to that. The pasture, praise God, that God has for you is full of joy. Praise God, it's full of peace. Amen. When you wear this yoke, remember, I want to wear this yoke. Praise God. Without this yoke, you might wander off into another pasture that looks good, but it ain't good. Say amen to that. Amen. You're not going, amen, very far. We can't make it if we don't wear the yoke of the Holy Ghost. Because the Holy Ghost leads us and guides us into all truth. Amen. I want you to know, don't let nothing pull you from your blessed situation. Amen. Don't let nothing pull you out of your blessed position. Praise God. Don't let nothing and nobody pull you from your blessed position. How many witnesses do I have? Amen. How many know you're blessed? Just shout, I am blessed. This yoke will keep you beside the still waters. Praise God. Now Isaiah 10:27. Amen. And it shall come to pass. The yoke shall be taken off thy shoulder. Matthew 11:27. This is a revelation yoke. What am I talking about? Amen. It's a yoke of knowing Jesus is with you all the time. Praise God. Just say the Holy Spirit is with me all the time. Praise God. Say the blood of Jesus is with me all the time. Praise God. This yoke keeps me in my grace place. Amen. What is my grace place saying? Amen. My grace place is saying it is already finished. Praise God. And what is my grace place saying? Amen. His grace is sufficient for me. It doesn't matter what the situation is. His grace is sufficient for me. It's sufficient for my health, and it's sufficient for my wealth. It's sufficient for my peace in the midst of a storm. His grace is sufficient. Amen. So when I leave right now by the blood of Jesus. Amen. With your stripes, I'm already healed. Oh, you sit your word and healed me. So it got to come in alignment to the word of God. Praise God, my bank account. Amen. Got to come in alignment with the word of God. For the 2 Corinthians 8:9, it tells you you should be rich. Because through the grace of our Lord and Savior, amen, though he was rich, he became poor, that we through his grace might become rich. Praise God. Then he said, I come that you might have life, and life more abundantly. Amen. Just have abundant life that belongs to me. Praise the name of the Lord. So whatever's out of balance, whatever's out of alignment, just take it to grace for and eradicate it. Because God, he sits high and he looks low. God is the judge. Praise God. And I want you to know he's on our side. Praise God. Amen. It doesn't matter what's going on in these times. God is on our side. Praise God. Amen. He's with you in the morning. He's with you in the noonday. Amen. With you when the sun goes down. Don't let no worry off you. Plague you in the midnight hour. Because God is with you. Come on, give him a hand of praise. Glory to God. Come on, shout hallelujah. Give him a great praise. Oh, Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 27, says, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. That word reveal is powerful. Amen. Say the word reveal. Amen. Come on, shout reveal. Amen. See, God wants to reveal some things to us. Praise God. God wants to reveal his word. Amen. It's just don't look at it as history. You got to look at it as a mystery. But he'll unfold the mysteries of the kingdom. Praise God. Because remember, Jesus said, whom do you say that I am? Amen. They were saying a lot of things. Praise God. This one said this. This one said that. Amen. But he said, whom do you say I, the Son of Man, am? And then Peter said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Praise God. And he said, amen, flesh and blood haven't revealed it to him. Praise God. And I'm going to put you on a rock. And upon this rock I'll build my church. And the very gates of hell won't prevail against you. And I'm going to give you some keys. These keys will open up every door. Amen. I'm going to give you the keys to the kingdom. And whatsoever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. And if you bind it, you don't permit it. And if you don't permit it on earth, God won't permit it in heaven. If you loose it, you permit it on earth. Keys. Amen. He gave you keys. you are.